How you doing, Mike?
Thank you, sir.
How you doing, Nicholas? Congrats on the film. Looks really good.
Thanks.
My question is, working with the Knick, I'm a fan of you from the Knick. What takeaways did you get from Steven that helps you create this film?
It was, for me, it was instrumental. I did have these grandiose visions when we first started. I think I even told people this, but I was like, yeah, it's going to be, you know, we're not going to shoot more than 12 hours a day. I had this vision that it was just going to be like a Steven Soderbergh said, like we would show up, shoot 8 hours, and we would go home, and it would be really easy and amazing and professional, and cut to us at like, you know, 2 a.m. in the morning in like 16 degree weather after like a, you know, a 15 hour day.
Nicholas is firing the location supervisor.
Yeah, Nick firing the location supervisor.
I'm doing all these jobs I didn't sign up for.
Yeah.
I'm boys with the cops now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But just being on set, watching somebody like Soderbergh direct, I mean, he's all about optimization. He's his own DP.
But I think we did that. I mean, I think it was like...
In a way, not the same way.
I mean, we spent... I think we were pretty, like, we would get into a place and you'd be like, you know what, this whole thing will work in one shot. Like,
yeah.
Literally this scene right here that's the poster. Like,
that
was a one-shot
totally.
Scene. And there were a lot of moments like that where it was like, well, the scene is really, you know, the dialogue, the connection, if we can achieve it in one shot. And so I think, there are a lot of moments in the movie that get pulled off, like, Soderbergh style.
For sure. And he does something better than anybody I've ever seen, which is scene comprehension. You could read a scene one way and imagine it. It's going to, you know, you're going to have a close-up here on the actor's monologue, and you're going to, maybe there'll be a move in here, there'll be coverage. And then he gets on set and he shoots it, and before you know it, you're done. And you have like a 5-page scene with 10 characters, and it's over. And so going into this, and especially shooting it in between the Knick, it definitely, it really sort of allowed me to think, like, really, what do we need here? What is the bare minimum, and what is the most economical, optimized way we could shoot this scene and still have it be interesting? And so that translated to a lot of shots that we would, like this scene, I think we did 26 times or something like that. I think this was the 18th take that we ended up using, but...
This scene, is this the scene where they also, the women get dropped off, and we pan with them as they sort of go around the corner and are...
Yeah.
Kind of still improvising a little bit,
yeah,
as you're going
exactly.
around. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, it was that sort of stick to your guns thing of like, just choose a shot, compose it and block it, and then just stay until you get it, you know? With Soderbergh, he'll do like one version of that or two versions and move on. And so that's the 45 minutes that it takes that you're on set shooting a 5 or 6 page scene and you're like, I'm done. He didn't even shoot my coverage. But with this, it was like, we have 15 days. We have to shoot as much footage as possible.